news from the Federal Reserve last night suggesting that the anticipated policy of rolling back its monetary easing will be a more gradual process than previously thought has helped shares recover some of the ground lost yesterday. However, here in the UK, monetary policy from the Bank of England particularly weighing on investors' minds ahead of the release of the minutes of the BOE's last policy meeting. That's all due later on today. Among small-cap news, Cyan Holdings has struck a strategic partnership with Brazil's Nobre de la Torre for its smart metering systems, which will allow the company to become one of the largest advanced meter infrastructure and automatic meter reading providers in the country. It's another encouraging development for Cyan, which recently struck a deal to provide Brazil's streets with energy-efficient lighting, a market estimated to grow by $8 billion by 2020. Sirius Minerals has unveiled a maiden reserves report for the York Potash project. The company stated that the project has 250 million tonnes of probable polyhalite reserves with a mean grade of 87.8%, while indicated mineral resources were estimated at 820 million tonnes with an average grade of 87.3%. This estimate is derived from just 1% of the entire potash area. Kefi Minerals said discovery in June at the 3K Hill has increased the JORC-compliant resource of the company at its Jabal Qutman gold prospect by a third. It also said that ongoing exploration work there continues to expand the mineralized system, which is yet to be closed off. Shanta Gold, meanwhile, has struck gold at its new Luika mine in Tanzania at lower depths and much higher grades than its current resource. New Luika has two main ore deposits, and drilling on the area there had consistently intersected gold at between 270 and 350 metres below surface. Quick update on some of the news headlines coming through on the earnings side on AIM. Oxford Pharmascience reported a 47% jump in first half revenues to £500,000. As it refocuses the business as a drug redevelopment company, outstripping total revenues for all of 2012 in the process. It came as the company opted to redevelop existing oral drugs to make them better and easier to take instead of the previous emphasis on its technology platforms. And wrapping up this look at some of the market movers on Wednesday, the oil and gas exploration company UMC Energy has revealed it's made a loss before tax in the first half of £844,000. It's not unusual for an exploration company of this kind to make a loss and cash almost $162,000 on the balance sheet. However, interim results from the company also underlined the prospectivity of its onshore and offshore assets in Papua New Guinea. Data there culled from last month's Competent Persons Report point to a 3C or possible resource of 73 million barrels of oil and 56 billion cubic feet of gas on the license. Let's look at some of the stocks on the move.